President Trump going after one of his favorite targets, last night's campaign rally in Nashville, the media. His vitriolic comments drummed up the crowd, encouraging some to turn against reporters in the audience, including our chief White House correspondent, Jim Acosta.
There they are, right back there. They're fake. They are fake. Look how many of them. Look how many. Oh, boy. That's a lot of people back there. That's a lot of people. Fake news.
Jim later tweeted out this photo, and he said there were plenty of people who came up to him with nice things to say. But CNN political analyst and New York Times White House reporter Julie Davis tweeted this. Depressing sight at Trump rally in Nashville. Adorable young boy, probably about my son's age, pointing iPhone at me and other reporters and snapping pics while screaming fake news. A child who will grow up believing a free and fair press is the enemy, a bad thing to be mocked and hated. And Jim Acosta is with me now. Wow. I mean, that's strong from Julie, but
yeah.
Tell me about your experience and how bad the heckling got.
Well, it got bad at one point towards the end of the rally. There was one man who was standing right in front of what we call, affectionately called, the press cage, the press area inside these Trump rallies, and he was yelling scumbag and that sort of thing at us for a good 20 minutes or so. There is some audio of that. We can play that for you and then paint the picture a little bit more for you, Brooke.
Okay.
Now, Brooke, it is a little surreal to hear that sort of stuff thrown at you while Tiny Dancer by Elton John is playing in the background. But, you know, I've been doing this for a while, so I'm not too put off by it. But, Brooke, I want to show you another picture. You just showed it a few moments ago. This gentleman who came up to me during the rally wearing a You Are Fake News T-shirt. We shook hands. We had a nice conversation, about 5 or 10 minutes. That was really emblematic of the vast majority of people in the Trump crowd there who came up to us. I thought it was fascinating. So many people came up to us, and sometimes, yes, they would express their frustrations with the media and so on and parrot things that they hear on Fox News and other, you know, conspiracy-minded websites that I won't mention by name. But by and large, after they vented those frustrations, they would just be nice to you and want to talk to you about what's happening in the news. And, you know, what dawned on me, Brooke, is that, you know, I really wonder whether Trump supporters are going to run out of anger before the president himself does. And, you know, I was starting to get the sense of that last night. So many people came up to us and said, and a few of them even said, more than a few of them said, thank you for what you do. We know that you really get targeted at the White House, but we appreciate what you're doing. And Brooke, my sense of it is that, you know, while he whips up, the president whips up this frenzy and tries to turn his crowd against us at these rallies, that there are many, many people there who just are perhaps enjoying the show and perhaps understand that some of this is an act. But in the long run, they may be coming out of this sense of hostility that he's put, you know, he's placed in many of them towards us. And, you know, that was, I think, you know, represented by that gentleman in the You Are Fake News T-shirt. He came up to me, had a nice 10-minute conversation about what was happening in the news. And, you know, my sense of it is that perhaps while the president, you know, seems to have this ability to divide and conquer and pit one crowd against another, at these rallies and so on, that maybe over time his supporters might say, you know what, this isn't working anymore. They may want to go binge watch something else.
I love that, and I love that you're so right. You know, it's like get out in the country and listen to what other people have to say, and then it's like when you end up face to face and having a conversation, you find out
that's right.
You actually aren't that much different than you initially thought.
We're all Americans.
Do want to ask you.
We are.
You called out the president's erroneous statement about how long, you know, African Americans in this country have been able to vote and for whom they have historically voted. Tell me about that.
Right. I mean, it's interesting. He calls us fake news. He whips up the crowd and gets them to call us fake news. But yet he's spreading fake news himself. He did it again last night talking on a a variety of subjects, once again saying that Mexico is going to pay for the wall on the border when we know that's never going to happen. But at one point he talked about African-American voters and said that they've been voting for Democrats over 100 years. Here's what he had to say.
African-Americans vote for Democrats for the most part, you know, vast majority. They've been doing it for over 100 years.
Now, either the president is peddling fake news himself there, or he hasn't read a history book and doesn't understand that the Voting Rights Act of 1965, signed by President Johnson, that is what really gave African Americans the right to vote all over this country, especially down south where there were so many voting barriers placed against them. It's just another indication of, you know, the president projecting onto us that which he is doing himself. He is spreading fake news, but he wants to call us fake news. It is sort of Alice in Wonderland through the looking glass type stuff. But Brooke, this is what happens all the time covering this president. He'll call us fake news and then spread some fake news of his own.
Just go back to that song. Don't know much about history.
That's
Jim Acosta.
Right.
Thank you very much.